What's up guys, welcome to another video, and today I'm going to show you 5 best exercises you can do to work the lower abs. Okay, before we start this video, all I want to say is that to actually see your abs, you need to have a decently low body fat percentage. So some people are different. So somebody might have 10%, some people might 15%, but they might have the same kind of visibility of abs, and that's just down to the genetics. You just need to get to where your body can see your abs, basically, and that's done through, obviously, intense training and calorie deficit. I've spoke to this before, and how to actually track your macros and how to calculate them to make sure you're in a deficit, but yeah, enough said. So these exercises are key because lower abs are quite ignored. So you see in a lot of people, the top abs are the ones that are popping, but see the lower abs, they can't see them as much. Say myself, I'm not genetically gifted in that kind of lower ab region, so I try and hit them as much as possible, more than the top. So I tend to do these exercises probably 3 or 4 times a week. Don't need to do that many. And it gets my abs stronger, more popping, because they are like any other muscle in the body. If you train them very hard, very intense, they will grow like any other body, any other muscle. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna say. Don't overtrain them, but they do recover very fast, like compared to any other muscle. So if you do want to train them daily, then that's okay, because they will recover. So we'll get right to it. Okay, so the first one is a lying leg raise, but I do this with a medicine ball. The reason I like the medicine ball is because that you need to actually control the ball, and it takes a bit of time, which I find more and more difficult compared to either doing it body weight or just using a weight up to your legs. So I like putting the ball between my legs, actually having to control it, so using your core to actually hold the ball while it comes down. I think I do between like 20, maybe 30 reps for this. Just try and get that kind of momentum, and try not to drop the ball, obviously. But I like this because you have to try and resist the ball from falling. For me, it works my core a lot more than just use my legs. So next exercise, what you want to do is it's a combined of two. So it's the flutters. So I do slow flutters plus the scissors, which I call them. So you're doing one rep of the scissors, so each leg, and then coming out to the side for your scissors. For this one, it's very tough. You want to try and make sure that your shoulders are up. So when your shoulders are up for this one, it engages the core a lot more. If you keep your shoulders down and you try and look above, it actually might hurt your lower back, and obviously the top of your legs will feel a bit more pressure, whereas you want to engage your abs, basically, because this is an ab exercise. So pulling your shoulders up, hands underneath bum, just taking it nice and slow. Don't need to go very fast for this one, and you will feel an absolute burn. So next one is the mountain climber. So getting in a plank position, sometimes I like to arch my back, just ever so slightly. So this one, all I do is just focus on the one leg. So this will be the right leg first, so 10 reps, then switch over to the left leg. So when I'm doing this, I try and keep the momentum going for the one leg, so try and keep it off the ground. So when I go back, I stretch it and even look up. So when I come back in, I try and get the knee towards the shoulder, and squeeze, contracting as hard as I can, try and get the squeeze of the abs, because that's what works the muscle, the squeeze and stretch. And then I switch over to the left leg, take a wee rest. Okay, so this one is a very important exercise. I never used to do this, but when I started doing it, I seen a dramatic difference in the strength of my lower abs. So for this one, is a lower ab hip raise. So when you come up, so I don't like to come all the way down my legs. I like to just kind of stop and keep my legs kind of bent. So when I do come up, I move my knees towards my chest and then I hip up. So I bounce my hips up and keep my legs straight. So when I do come up, I'm squeezing and contracting the abs. My hands are just in a position to keep me balanced. Another reason I like this exercise is because that it's working your core a lot more when you're trying to come up, and trying to stay stable and obviously not fall to the side. But yeah, so try this exercise. I like to go between like maybe 12 to 15 reps on this one. If you can do more, brilliant. If you can do less, quality over quantity, I always say, and make sure you're contracting those abs. So next exercise and final exercise is the hanging leg raise. So you can do this in two stages. First, if you've never done this before, I recommend just trying to get the knees up. So you can see in this video, I do it in two steps. So I bring my knees up and then I follow all the way up. So the reason why I like to do the second stage is because it actually contracts my abs a lot more. I could just rep out the knees and I wasn't really feeling the contraction in my abs. So that's the reason why I go up to my knees and also follow right up. So when I follow right up, I'm actually crunching the abs. You want to focus on slow, controlled and quality reps for everyone. So yeah, if you're just starting here, maybe focus on just getting the knees up first and then possibly switch into a few reps like this. Now, the reason why I actually think this is a very hard exercise because your grip is tested. So if you've not got a good grip strength, maybe just switch into the lying leg raise until you get your strength, your abs, and obviously working on the upper body a bit before you can actually hold on to your own body weight. So that's it, guys. That's the 5 perfect exercises you can do for your lower abs to get them absolutely popping. So the rep range has changed between each one, like I said. So you want to try and get to a tough but comfortable kind of range at the start. Start building them up. So even the first exercise, the lying leg raise, I do a lot more reps on that. So I might do 20 reps on that compared to like the hanging leg raises, when I can only get like even there about 9.5, 10. So yeah, so try these out the next time. You will feel the burn totally if you're not used to it. So try like maybe 3 rounds of this, 2 to 3 rounds. I don't think any more will do any benefit. So just try and focus on just contracting the abs, and make sure you're actually testing them. Do this after a workout or even do it just on the one day, or when you've got a bit of time. And I suggest maybe doing this maybe 3 times or 4 times a week, if you want to see a real difference. And yeah, just let me know how you get on. So guys, if you're wanting to see any more videos like this, just comment down below. Tell me what videos you want to see, any exercise videos you want to see specifically. Yeah, smash the thumbs up button, comment like I said, and subscribe if you have not subscribed already. So yeah, stay positive, stay grateful, and I will see you in the next one.